YouTube, welcome back. The Fay Enchantress. She's gonna be continuing to lead my forces to what is hopefully victory here. Let's get things kicked back. I know I haven't expanded a lot, but I mean, we have made big strides, even if it doesn't look like it from a land standpoint. We have a lot of allies. We certainly have enemies at this point, too. I'm gonna see if I can get Estalia to surrender. Okay, the orcs are gonna run off. Let's go in here and see if Estalia will surrender.
The time for talk is over.
Really?
Make your demands.
Estalia is not going to surrender, and you can see here that they're trying to sail around me and maybe try and backstab me or something. That's just infuriating. I will come to your aid. I gotta get back up here. We need to work on the elves. We'll have to work on Estalia. I'm barely making any money at this point, but at least we're making some. It's better than not making any. That's exactly what I thought they'd do. They're going to go ruin my settlement at Brion, which is going to hurt terribly. We could try and attack this force, but I haven't replenished. So if anything, I'm going to try and speed back here. Brion probably won't be able to... No, it's not going to be able
Absolutely
to hold.
Not.
This is infuriating.
I protect Bretonnia.
I swear by everything sacred in the lands of Bretonnia that Estalia will pay a dear price if they raise that settlement. They will pay a huge price. Missile resistance, magic resistance. Not worried about magic resistance all that much. Visor. Yeah, none of these things really seem all that handy down here either. Let's go with Power Drain, get us more magic reserve. I hate you, Estalia. I really hate you. You see how they sailed around me and made a beeline? I thought the Wood Elves were at war with me. Interesting. Okay. Alright, what's Estalia gonna do? Oh my gosh, they sailed around me. Talk about fortune of the lady here, folks. Wow, something that's actually gonna help me? To what do I owe this great pleasure? Minus 20% for buildings. Let's just go with the growth.
Yes.
Can we reach the settlement?
Yes.
Alright, we can intercept these Estalian forces here and put an end to their murderous intentions. We got lucky. I don't know why they did not attack the port here. It was incredible foolishness on their part. But I'm certainly grateful for it. Let's try and unify Bretonnia here. It'll only take 11 turns. I think that'll be... research well spent. Estalia is probably going to just take off and run. What do these guys want? Yes. Good. It's good to see Bretonnia uniting against their enemies rather than some of the other campaigns I've played, like the infighting amongst the Bretonnians was just absurd. Look at Estalia just takes off running towards... Are they at war with Paravan? If so, then they may be trying to go hurt my allies here. I'm going to chase them down. I don't want to let them hit my ally in the back either while we're in the middle of what is a pretty serious war. Now they can stay in front of me and get to Kineo, or whatever the name of that
Greetings.
Is.
Who seeks my...
Join the war against Musion. Not just yet, but I will. Okay. They are defended there. Now they're gonna try and make a beeline back. I mean, look at these idiots just running around in every direction at once. Strength rate 6, and they're begging me for peace. If you want peace, how about you pay me for it? You can pay me more then. Okay. They can't just straight hit my capital here without having siege equipment, so I'm just going to chase them. AI here just running away from me like a bunch of numbskulls. Why fight when you can run? Run, Tylea, run. Making Forrest Gump look lazy. All right, they ran right into dwarf lands. Or elf lands. It's fine. Run, you cowards.
I am the Fae.
How would we actually get to the vaults here? So we have to come in. Ardwalon in this other place, they could send armies out to me easier than I can send armies in after them.
No.
Let's block them into elf lands. Yeah, if we block these guys in the elf lands, then they'll suffer attrition. There we go.
By Sigma, no!
Now that said, I'm gonna haul off down here and I don't think the elves are gonna give me a whole lot of grief. I really don't. Oh, how I want this royal stables. So bad. This is irritating though because I haven't been able to put the Green Knight to any good use because the elves won't come out of their lands and I can't go into their lands without suffering massive attrition. So it just kind of puts us in a standstill at the moment. We can't build up this farm because we don't have the right building chain here, so this farm is almost kind of pointless. I'm sitting here trying to think what we should do with it. You can put a smithy in a level 2. If we put the smithy... Actually, it would make more sense. We had the carpenter's workshop here. We could put the farm. But we'd have to be up to a level 5. Yeah, there's not a lot of things that we can do here. It's unfortunate, but it's just kind of the case. Farm's just kind of wasted at the moment, but it gives us a little bit of income, so we'll just have to deal with it. We'd actually have to have the water wheel to make any use of it. I mean, it's kind of making... This is why I like the tier 4 settlement mod. It just gives you more flexibility and makes this building stuff make more sense. I think the only thing that makes sense to build here now is the smithy.
You seek the lady.
And since we're building a smithy, we might as well level up the rally field. Potentially get better infantry. I hate this because now we're wasting the Green Knight, so I need to go.
No evildoer may receive the blessings of the
You better be begging for peace. Yes, you are good. That payment can get a little bit larger. Well, if that's the best you can do.
Those seeking my counsel.
Okay, once again. Payment better get a little bit larger. Yeah, you cheapskates, whatever. It's 1200 gold for me. 1200 gold that is certainly needed.
Traveling the land.
Let's go finish off Estalia. How many more turns do I get the Black Knight? Or the Green Knight? 5 turns? Crap. We need a battle. We need a battle soon.
Who calls me Hex?
This is a fairly wasted use of the Green Knight. I'm not real happy about it. It's my fault, though. I called him thinking that we were about to have a lot of fighting on our hands, but Estalia kind of wienered around me and led me off on a chase, and then the elves won't fight. Your ally declares war on the Empire. Way to go, Baston. Way to go. Alright, well, we're going to enter the war on the side of our ally. That's a chivalrous thing to do, but I don't know why we shouldn't be trying to work with the Empire.
Who wishes the Grail? Through forest and glade.
Okay, we're gonna push up on Estalia. Here we go. Let's see what we can do here. Alright. If these guys want peace, once again, they're gonna have to pay up. $600? Nah, you can do better than that, but since it's not giving me another option now, whatever. I should have tried it higher without making him disagree there. That's frustrating. Alright, well, whatever. We got some money out of our enemies. It's going to help pay for the improvement of some different buildings we need. And the Green Knight has 3 turns remaining, so we should be able to try and generate a fight.
Fay Enchantress.
If we have to siege them, we won't. But if we can convince them to fight us outside of a siege, then we have a chance. We got 2 turns left with the Green Knight.
Enchantress.
All we can do is attack. It's saying that they have overwhelmingly good odds against us. They may. It's possible. But with the Green Knight on our hands, I feel like we have some pretty good chances. I'm going to go ahead and start building siege equipment, but at the same time, I'm hoping that we'll get counterattacked. Or that maybe Estalia, I don't know, I'd like to get counterattacked so that I can actually get in a battle. I'd like to use the Green Knight in battle, since that's what I called them hither to help me with. Please attack me, Estalia, please. The odds are in your favor, right? No, they're not going to attack me. They're just going to sit here and try and use their agent against me. This is infuriating.
Witness her power.
So I'm going to lose the Green Knight here, which is infuriating. Absolutely infuriating.
I'll ignore that.
Then they'll probably attack me too, by the way. Let's see what happens. Might as well invest our money here. Actually, let's save our money and build up the royal stables because we're so close. I want to have access to those knights should I ever get the money to field them, which shouldn't be too terribly long from now. Bordello. Way to go, we just made peace, you idiots. I gotta enter the war on the side of my allies, so maybe they'll beg me for peace again and I'll get more money. We'll see. Dadgummit. Ah, and the beastmen show up. Perfect timing. Look at this, Estalia saved by the beast. I'm not giving up though, I'm gonna keep sieging Estalia. If they wanna sit here, I'm gonna siege their trash out. Hide behind your walls. Run and hide, Estalia, run and hide. Sick of this. Now that they've damaged my units, look at this. We got assault units. One agent came in and killed, like, what, almost 100 men?
Come for.
And then the Bray Herds are right behind us now, too. This is infuriating.
For Bretonnia.
I'm gonna have to break the siege.
I can't.
We've lost the blessing of the lady. Yep. Perfect. That's exactly what I wanted.
Attack.
I'm not gonna declare war on these guys. Maybe they'll kill Estalia for me.
My journey continues.
Now I'm gonna have to flee back again. This is just, I'm absolutely irritated right now. Like, extremely irritated. Start working on some of the economic stuff. The AI is irritating. Yeah, Estalia is sitting on this big army, and they just sit there in their settlement. Won't fight. Won't make anything interesting out of any of this. And my allies just keep pulling me into war after war after war here. Look at this. There's two Bray Herds, and one of them gets to spawn all the way back in my lands. Oh, so yes. Now I'm going to be in a foot race.
Going forth.
I hate how the beastmen just get random spawns like this.
Be still, Sivaron. Let them speak.
Okay, end your non-aggression pact then, elf. Jaggedhorn tribe is going to make for Brion. Again, they can put a serious hurt on me if they get there before me, which they will. I can only hope to deter them by getting right up behind them like this. But if they raise that settlement, it's going to cost me a fortune. So much so that I probably can't maintain my upkeep. Okay, they've just run on. I'm still going to chase them.
I protect Bretonnia.
You're not getting away, you beast freaks. Maybe there's fights we can take somewhere else. Since we're at war with the Empire, maybe we can go take some of their lands easier than we could something else. We need land. We've got to have a means to expand, to maintain knights. Sick of these jagged horn fruitcakes running away from me. They're in raiding stance too, so I'm not really sure how they're staying so far in front of me. Let's ignore that peace treaty because my allies aren't going to take one with them right now anyway. I just want to fight. Can I please have a battle? Or is it like pre-programmed for the AI to just run away from me?
Who wishes the grail?
Okay, well, the beast freaks went under the beast path somewhere, and I have no idea where they've gone now.
I am called forth.
Is there no one who wants a battle? Is this all we do is we run? Just run, run, run. That would be handy. Each of your regions can sustain an extra peasant. Okay, let's work on that. How long has it been since I've had a good fight, and I can't expand because there's nowhere good to expand to, and every time I try to, I end up just running all over the map like an idiot chasing people because they, like, and then the one time I lay siege, like, they spawn a bunch of beastmen and save the other faction, like the two are working together or something.
You seek the lady? I shall.
Okay, I've really had enough of this. I'm going to destroy someone before this episode's over. This lady is angry. And I know I'm not a lady. I'm talking about the lady in the campaign. Got it. This gets a chance. There we go. The Empire's got quite a few armies roaming around. Hope my ally knew what they were getting themselves into. If I declare war on the Beastmen now, though, this other stack's going to be behind me. I'm assuming that the beastmen must have gotten their face kicked in right there, so here's to hoping. I don't know, how many more turns is it going to take before I can get a fight? And another province, for that matter. Maybe we can get Paravon to... No, those beastmen didn't get killed. They were actually right there momentarily. Alright, well, I think we're in a decent position now, though. We can attack these beastmen. They're raiding against us anyway, so we've got Scar and his army. That is so many Minotaurs. Wow. I'm undeterred. Our cavalry can quickly mop up their archers, and our own archers should be able to mow down their Minotaurs. While our heroes kind of help hold back the tide. What do you call that dude? Sigor. Yeah, the Sigor is an issue. The AI is extremely accurate with their Saigor throws. They get tons of kills with every shot. My trebuchet is not going to do a whole lot to this particular army of beastmen. I wonder if we can use the Curse of Heir. Probably won't help a whole lot. I don't know, the speed debuff might be helpful. Let's see if we can draw the fire of the Saigor away from our infantry with my leadership. Okay, Knights Errant. Okay, I think we're ready. We've got a lot of magic reserves. We're at 168 magic reserve. So we're going to have magic coming out of our ears if we can recharge it fast enough. Slow down all these Minotaurs. They're already tired from their stance, I think. There we go. Ooh, that Saigor. Let's go mob the Saigor. Let's fall back a little bit. Told you to run, actually. Hey, let's start working. Some of our knights to destroy the Angor Raiders. There we go. Taking down Minotaurs in a pretty big hurry. Did get a few enemies back behind us. Stop chasing their bows. Oh yeah, we're getting some beautiful kills on their bows now. Let's intercept these spears. Try and hold down their lord here too, so our knights can get the job done back here. Okay, Minotaurs are being driven back.
Fay Enchantress.
Okay, we're gonna try and take out their lord here. These spears are chasing my cavalry in a most annoying fashion. Passing of some of these units. Okay, some of the Minotaurs are coming back. Let's make short work of them. Let's leave their lord here. I want to go get these spears off my cavalry. Come on, get through here. Minotaurs are about to drop. I lost some of my knights errant here. One of their Minotaur units is still fairly healthy. Got into the back of those Angor spears though. Their Saigor is fleeing away from me, so let's just let him flee. There we go. Minotaur should drop. They don't have much armor. Okay, so let's clean up archers. It's now just an archer cleanup mission here. There we go. Minotaurs are down. Alright, finally got some satisfaction. go. Chase him. I'm gonna hunt down a bunch of these Ungor raiders. Some fleeing off in that direction. Hunt down some more Ungor. Alright, I think we're gonna be good to finish off this battle. We've gotten some decent chevrons started on some of these units through here. Almost to the edge of the map, but we're gonna catch some of these Ungor raiders. If not all of them. There we go. Good. Melted away a whole bunch of those numbers. Picked up some experience for our cavalry. Those Grail Guardians, though, look at that. 123 kills, barely scathed. Double silver chevron. We're starting to get some chevrons in our trebuchet, which would be good if we run into large infantry stacks. Hopefully we can get the blessings of the lady back here. Got some physical resistance. Hey, where are you at, lady? Where's your blessings? Girdle of gold. 15% ward save. Sounds like a good plan, though a golden girdle sounds relatively uncomfortable. Do I want to put my guy up on a Pegasus? I think so. I don't know why we wouldn't want to, and then we'll work on Woundmaker. Alright, so we've got the Pegasus. Alright, at least we got some combat in here. I know there's going to be more beastmen to deal with.
Those seeking my counsel.
The Empire continues to want peace. Alright. It's going to be so hard to get those elves out of their little hidey holes. Oh, look, that Estalian army's back in our lands. But the bigger threat is going to be from the beast Bray herd that's up to the north. So we'll have to intercept it.
You seek me? I will come to your aid.
Let's get into Brion there, and we should increase our replenishment rates. Let's go ahead and build up the barracks just while we have the money for it. That Estalian army can't do anything effective to our capital, so that's no concern. And then hopefully we can face down this other Bray herd. Yeah, they're gonna siege me. Dream on. Oh, look who came out of the woodwork now that it's convenient. Yeah. How very convenient.
You seek prophecy.
Especially since I know there's a Bray herd hidden somewhere up here.
You seek the lady?
Yep, I knew it. So, you spotted an army waiting to ambush, undeterred by their discovery. The enemy is moving to intercept, so opportunity to intercept. So, I'm gonna actually... You were defending against the Jagged Horde Tribe, but it still gives me good chances. Whatever, I don't feel like defending, so I'm just gonna auto-resolve this. And then I'm gonna turn around and get ready to go spank the, Is that a potion of toughness? Oh, I think it was. Talisman of Endurance, ward save. Alright, Blessing of the Ladies gained. Good.
Enchantress.
Ah, we can't reach these guys, so now they're gonna run off. That's just flat irritating. What if I do this thing that gives me an extra 10% campaign movement? I wonder if we can reach them then.
What
no.
Do you see?
Crap! If we get back into the settlement here, that should increase my replenishment so that we can then double back and get ready to defend against Estalia. So, still not able to expand, really, but at least we're getting something done. Let's give her the lady's mantle. Alright, almost finished with this episode. Wissenland wants a peace treaty. Whatever, not right now. Especially if my guys are kicking the crap out of you. Okay, that's weird. One of the... Yeah, and look, see, these guys are going to go up there and just kind of hunker down and wait for an opportunity to come back and hurt Brion. They are so annoying. I'm going to push up. Oh, yeah, we're not going to run out of supplies. We lost one of our questing knights. That's irritating. Must have been an auto-resolve where we got screwed over there. I don't dare use the green knight because I know what happens. As soon as I pull out the green knight, everybody takes off running. Let's work on Woundmaker. End the turn. And we should be...
Let them speak.
Okay, if these idiots want a peace treaty, if they'll pay me for it, I'm on board. But it says their powers, economic power is very weak. But they're still offering. There we go. Okay, Estalia is going to try and jack me up with an agent. And they succeeded, but in the end, no damage to my men.
Not likely.
Alright, well, we're going to save it here, and I'll pick it up next time with the big battle against Estalia. Once we face roll Estalia here, we should be able to... Oh, I thought they settled here. Once we face roll Estalia in the battle, then we should be able to focus elsewhere. Heir of Carthage, signing out for now. See you soon.